Advisors to the U.S. Food and Drug Administration are recommending the use of Pfizer-BioNTech's COVID-19 vaccine on children ages 5 to 11. Here's the full story.
So this concludes the vote. Out of 18 voting members, 17 voted yes, and we had one abstain.
A panel of expert FDA advisors on Tuesday voted to recommend the use of Pfizer's COVID-19 vaccine for children ages 5 to 11. The vote marks an important regulatory step toward reaching about 28 million children for inoculation, most of them back in school for in-person learning. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration is not bound to the advice of its outside experts, but usually follows it. In a clinical trial, Pfizer's vaccine showed 90.7% efficacy against the coronavirus in children aged 5 to 11, the company said. While children become seriously ill or die far less often than adults from COVID-19, some develop complications, and cases in unvaccinated kids have risen due to the highly transmissible Delta variant. One FDA official said there had been close to 100 deaths in that age group so far and 1.9 million infections. Outbreaks have also caused school closures and disrupted the education and socialization of children. Inoculating the age group could speed the pace of immunization in the U.S., where the percentage of fully vaccinated people has fallen behind countries like the U.K. and France. FDA staff said the likely vaccine benefits in that age group clearly outweigh the potential harms, including the rare risk of heart inflammation. The World Health Organization since May has been urging rich countries to reconsider plans to vaccinate children and instead donate COVID shots to poorer countries. Pfizer is seeking clearance for a lower 10 microgram dose of the vaccine in children versus 30 micrograms for everyone over the age of 12. Once the FDA authorizes the vaccine for younger children, a CDC advisory panel will make a recommendation on the administration of the vaccine. The CDC director will make the final call.
The Canadian province of British Columbia is set to begin offering COVID-19 booster shots to everyone over the age of 12 starting January of next year. The province's health officer says that eligible age groups will be invited to book shots before the year ends. Residents of long-term and assisted living facilities are already eligible. The expanded coverage makes British Columbia the first Canadian province to significantly widen eligibility for boosters. Other Canadian provinces have so far committed to providing booster shots only to the residents of long-term care facilities, to people with immunodeficiency issues, or to those over a certain age. Overall, more than 82% of Canadians ages 12 and older have been fully vaccinated against the coronavirus. Here at home, the chairperson of the National Vaccine Operations Center admits that it's highly unlikely that the Philippines will be able to hit its target of fully vaccinating 70% of the adult population against COVID-19 before the end of the year. Health Undersecretary Mir Nakabutahe says that this may only be achieved in the first quarter of 2022. She adds that the goal is now to get at least 50% of the country's 110 million population fully vaccinated this 2021. As of October 25th, almost 26 million individuals have been fully inoculated against COVID-19. Now that's 33.65% of the government's initial 70% target. The Philippines' COVID-19 death toll breaches 42,000. That's after the health department recorded 135 more fatalities Tuesday. 4,393 new infections were also confirmed, bringing the number of active cases to over 53,000, the lowest since July 22nd. The current 8.5% positivity rate is also the lowest in over 7 months. The Octa Research Group attributes the decline in new cases, especially in Metro Manila, to the widening of the country's vaccination coverage.
Well, we're on the right track. We still need testing. We still need to vaccinate more people. And although the coverage in the NCR is very high already, I think we're almost at 8 million people vaccinated in the NCR. The coverage in the provinces is not yet that high. So we still need to address these concerns. It's not just a supply issue. What we're seeing, in fact, and based on our surveys, there is a significant hesitancy in many provinces outside the NCR outside the NCR region. So we need to address these concerns because vaccination is very important moving forward. Even though, you know, we have contained the pandemic, the threats are still there. And if we vaccinate more people, the threats will be lessened. And this is what we're seeing in many countries that have vaccinated a significant portion of their population.
A public-private task force is calling for the reopening of public transportation and schools in the highly vaccinated areas of Metro Manila. Task Force T3, or Test, Trace, Treat, says all efforts must now be put towards the easing of the quarantine restrictions in Metro Manila to alert level 2 by early November. The health department has said that the chances of the region being placed under a lower alert level are quite high amid the continued decline in COVID-19 cases. The task force is also batting for a faster vaccine rollout outside of the capital region as more shots arrive in the country.